just straight up changed the song on my phone. You wanted to listen to this one again? When we hit the bottom, nothing gonna stop us. Climb to the top and you know, we could be the greatest ones who never made it. Yeah, I could be talking to you. Happy good morning. Welcome back to Hopescope. I am your host, the Leggin Queen. This is the real star of the show, co-host Leo. We are your number one source for all things fit fashion. Okay, you can sit down now. I am particularly excited about today's review. This is a brand that I've been loving for the past year or so. Loving so much, in fact, that I reached out to them and I was like, hey, do you want to send me some stuff to review? And they agreed. So we've got lots of good stuff for you today. Activewear, swimsuits, two broken nails. Gosh dang it, Hope, why are you like this? White Fox, for those of you that are unaware, is a very popular Instagram brand that is based out of Australia. My first piece of advice when shopping here is when you're looking at the prices, realize that it's in Australian dollars. So it's gonna feel like it's a lot more expensive than it actually is for us US gals. Second is they do ship worldwide. Everything comes in an extra small to an extra extra large. I got everything in a size small today. I do have all of my personal measurements down below in the description box if you want to use them for reference, as well as all the links to shop everything. We're gonna start with the activewear. The first item that I have is the Sundays tank. This is part of the Sarah's Day White Fox collaboration. I did do a review on the collection a while back, so everything that I don't talk about in this video is probably in that video, so make sure to go check it out when you're done. And if you don't know who Sarah's Day is, she's a fitness YouTuber and the cutest dang thing you ever will see. This is the baby pink. It also comes in white and I think black. It is $34. When I first saw this, I was like, why on earth would I pay $34 for a tank top? I never wear tank tops. And then I saw Sarah style it with the pink set that came out in the first launch. I was sold. It has a nice high neck and round low armholes, almost like muscle tank style. But it's more fitted than just a generic muscle tee. Has these cute little slits on the side, and this looks so cute tied up into a crop top as well. This fabric is a semi-sheer, very lightweight, has the cute little Sarah's Day logo on the back. I like it. Next up, this item might be my most worn piece of clothing of all time. The drop crotch pants. These are actually just the white ones from the first launch, but this time I got myself the white midnight ones. They also come in black and olive with white stripes. They are $45 and worth every single cent. At first, I didn't know how I felt about them. The drop crotch kind of looked a little, you know, saggy diapery, but they have grown on me. These are also part of the Sarah's Day White Fox collection. They have an elastic waistband with a drawstring, so you can adjust it. They are definitely meant to fit oversized, and then they taper down at the bottom. They have nice big pockets on them, and they're super lightweight. They're made from a cotton elastane material. Just trust me on this one, guys. Are you guys ready to be introduced to my favorite workout set ever? I don't mean to be dramatic, but literally ever. This is the set that when me and my body just aren't seeing eye to eye, you know, I'm like,
why you gotta be so bloated?
And she's like,
why you gotta eat so much ice cream?
This is the set that I reach for.
Not only
is it ridiculously flattering, but it is so functional. It's the White Jasmine set. We'll start with the sports bra. I got it in olive. It also comes in this olive with black detail, and then the midnight. The top is $45. I love this fabric. It's like a plushy, slick, just all around beautiful fabric. It has nice thick straps, so it's very comfortable. It doesn't dig in at all. And then it does have removable cut pads that are like crazy padded for a sports bra. Definitely a solid medium support sports bra. And then the White Jasmine leggings. Once again, I got them in the olive with the white detail. They also come in olive with the black or the midnight, but this is my absolute favorite combination. They're $60. They have a high waist with a drawstring waistband. Don't let that scare you though, because the drawstring hits right at your natural waist, and it is the most flattering thing. And it also doesn't show sweat. So that's what I mean when I say that it's super functional. They are a 7/8 length, which I think is a perfect length because it's kind of like a capri on people like me that are a little bit taller. But if you're shorter, you don't have to worry about them being ridiculously long. They are squat proof, but this print was printed on a white material. So if you stretch them way out, you'll notice that the material goes white.
but it doesn't go see-through. If it's sold out, I know that there is going to be a big restock at some point this month. I also wanted to try some of their other activewear that wasn't part of the Sarah's Day collection. The first one that I got is the Chloe sports bra. This is the Ash Mauve. It also comes in maroon and black. It's $45. It's just kind of like a basic racer back sports bra. It has the logoed elastic waistband running along the bottom, which every brand and their dog is doing this. You need one in your life. It's just a matter of what brand do you want plastered across your body. It has removable cup pads. Honestly, I would suggest sizing down because there's so much stretch to it. I think you'll get a lot better compression and support if you do. And don't worry, they have leggings that match. They have crop tops that match. You can get a whole set decked out in this. I didn't mind this. This was a good piece. The Surrey lace-up legging. Really cool to look at, really beautiful in theory, underwhelmed. I just don't think they're very functional is all. They were $83, so they're definitely one of, if not the most expensive pair of leggings that they have. I don't think I'll work out in them. They have a high waistband, which I'm not a fan of because this whole thing is an elastic, but the material that it's made out of is like a second skin material. There's no compression to it. I just don't find them to be that flattering in the lower tummy area. They are full length with a functional lace-up design, but the weird part is it just keeps coming. You're supposed to wrap this around your ankle. I can only imagine how many times during a workout this would come undone. And then I would come undone. Overall, the quality is there. It's made from a nylon polyester material that is very nice. They feel very breathable, but just due to the color, I think that they would show sweat. Like I said, just not a pair that I would grab if I was about to do a really intense workout. I have a very mixed review about the next one. Number one complaint being, why are these in the activewear section? Do not buy these with the intention of wearing them to the gym. That disclaimer being said, this is a trend I can get behind. These are the Slinky Bike shorts. I asked you guys on my Instagram story what you thought of them, and the reviews, I can't even say that they were mixed. Most of you hated them. I think it's more popular in Australia and the UK and stuff than it is in the US right now. So this is the metallic mint. It also comes in black, sand, and charcoal. And they were $30. I think that they're really flattering. These particular shorts don't show cellulite at all. They smooth you out. And this metallic, the light just hits your little bum in all the right places. I also actually really love the length of these, call me crazy, but I am not a short shorts kind of gal. I'm actually super self-conscious about my legs, my thighs in particular, so the more that's covered, the better. They have this elastic waist, which sits really high up, and they're just completely made from a polyester material. I say they're not for working out because they don't have any compression to them, but I think that these look super cute with that sweater that I just showed you. We're gonna move on to some swimwear. I have thoroughly enjoyed all of the swimsuits that I have gotten from White Fox so far. The quality seems to be real great. I got one bikini set. It's this little baby blue guy. The top is the Hacienda bikini top. How tiny does that look? I didn't think it was gonna fit, but it actually didn't look bad. It's $41, which is a little bit on the higher end side of things as opposed to the swimsuits that I usually buy. It's made out of this ribbed material. I am digging the ribbed material lately. I just feel like it holds its shape really, really well over time. This is baby blue, but it also comes in Tuscany, yellow, white, red, and black. It has this cute knot front detail. And then on the back, it has some adjustable straps and then the silver clasp closure with the White Fox logo on it. It's also mesh lined. I was so nervous when I pulled these out of the bag. Like, they look small. But that's because they're meant to be a really high waist, and this part is meant to fit around your natural waist, basically not your hips. So the small actually fit pretty nice. These are the Tula bottoms. It comes in all of the colors that I just named. It is $34. See, so that's what I mean. This ends up being $75 for the set, which that's a little expensive in my opinion. I love these bottoms. I don't think those words have come out of my mouth ever. I have had a very hate-hate relationship with swimsuit bottoms. I feel like they are the perfect cheeky cut. I love how high-waisted they are. Not everybody's down with that trend, but I am. And it's made from that same ribbed material, which I just think is really flattering. And like I said, it's really functional too. Everything else is a one piece because I'm totally team One Piece this summer. I'm so glad that trend is coming back. The Saint-Tropez One Piece. I got tangerine, but it comes in literally 20 colors. Like, I'm not gonna list them all because it's literally 20 of them. This is $41. It has a nice low back and a scoop neck. Very cheeky bottom. And then it has this cute little rose gold detail on the back of the swimsuit. The material definitely doesn't feel cheap. I like it. This next one is my favorite of all the one pieces. I just think it's so beautiful. It's a little sexy. It's the Como one piece. This is the white with rose gold detail. It also comes in black with a silver detail. It is completely ribbed and it has this beautiful corset detail. That is my favorite thing ever. It has this deep V front. The deep V in the back is really cute too. Usually I have to size up to mediums for most swimsuits, but I feel like these ones run true to size. And the last swimsuit, I have very mixed feelings on. You will have to let me know what you think of this trend because I just don't know. This is the Playa del Rey. I got it in red and it also comes in black. It was $60, so it's a little bit pricey. Maybe it's just not a medium or large titty committee piece because it looks really cute on the girl in the pictures, but on me, I just don't know if I'm feeling. If I would have been able to adjust the straps and kind of like pull it up a little bit higher, maybe it would have done more for me, but it's just giving me the illusion of granny boobies for some reason. But it has a cute little cutout in the middle, and then I love the back of it, how it comes down into this deep V. I don't know. Let me know what you think of it. The last item that I have, it didn't really fit into either of the categories at all, but I have to share it with you because it's my absolute favorite thing.
It's the
teddy coat. I love these with all my heart. I bought the red one a while back. It's $98. Yes, I cringed when I hit the place order button. I loved it so much that I had to get the khaki one too. And it also comes in camel and cream. They do come in one size. It fits very oversized. Like, let me just... Like, it goes on with ease over a sweatshirt. It has a nice collar and the nice big pockets on both sides that are silk lined. Okay, that's it for my little White Fox haul. Overall, I really do truly love this brand. As always, if you have a brand that you would love to see me review, comment down below, let me know what it is. Until then, Leo and I will see you guys in the next video. Say bye, YouTube.